your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host Swati Ajit, and these are the major news stories of Wednesday, October 2nd, 2024. The Israeli military announced it was deploying regular infantry and armored units for ground operations in Lebanon. The move increased pressure on Hezbollah as Israel prepared to respond to Iranian missile strikes. A Malayali was among three killed in a helicopter crash in Pune, Maharashtra. The tragic incident occurred on Wednesday morning when the helicopter crashed and caught fire. Two women officers of the Indian Navy, Lieutenant Commander Dilna K and Lieutenant Commander Rupa A, embarked from Goa on a challenging expedition to circumnavigate the globe covering 21,600 nautical miles over 8 months. A local court in Uttar Pradesh said the objective of Love Jihad was to establish dominance by certain anti-social elements of a particular religion against India through demographic warfare and international conspiracy. Dissident MLA PV Anwar said he would form a new political party in Kerala that will contest all coming elections in the state. Let's get into the details. The Israeli military announced on Wednesday that it is sending regular infantry and armored units to join ground operations in Lebanon. This move increases pressure on Hezbollah as Israel prepares to respond to Iranian missile strikes. While already engaged in conflict with Hamas in Gaza, Israel is strengthening its military presence in southern Lebanon after being attacked by Iran. This escalation raises concerns about a broader conflict in the oil-producing Middle East. India expressed deep concern and urged for restraint and emphasized the need to protect civilians as Israel prepared to retaliate against a series of Iranian missile strikes. A Malayali was among three killed in a helicopter crash in Pune, Maharashtra. Girish Kumar Pillai, a native of Kundarakollam, was a retired Air Force pilot. The tragic incident occurred on Wednesday morning when the helicopter crashed and caught fire. The aircraft operated by Delhi-based private aviation company had taken off from the Oxford Golf Course helipad and was en route to Juhu in Mumbai. Preliminary reports confirmed that the victims included two pilots and an engineer. Two women officers of the Indian Navy, Lieutenant Commander Dilna K and Lieutenant Commander Rupa A, on Wednesday embarked from Goa on a challenging expedition to circumnavigate the globe covering 21,600 nautical miles over 8 months. As they began their journey, Chief of the Naval Staff Admiral Dinesh K. Tripathi highlighted that the two women officers represent an India that defies societal norms. He stated that they are eager to explore new frontiers. Furthermore, he mentioned that this expedition will also aid in advancing national scientific research. The objective of Love Jihad is to establish dominance by certain antisocial elements of a particular religion against India through demographic warfare and international conspiracy, a local court in UP has observed. Additional District Judge Ravi Kumar Devakar said Hindu girls are being lured into love for the sake of illegal conversions and create conditions similar to those in Pakistan and Bangladesh in India. Devakar said that illegal conversions pose a significant threat to the country's unity, integrity and sovereignty as he heard a case involving marriage under false identities, relationships and abortion on Monday. Dissident MLA PV Anwar on Wednesday said he will form a new political party in Kerala that will contest all the coming elections in the state. Anwar, who had won from Nilambur constituency as the left candidate with whom the CPM has severed all ties, said that the issues raised by him have become a movement that will in turn turn into a political party. The Nilambur MLA also referred to Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan's recent reported statements about gold smuggling and hawala cases in Malappuram district and alleged that they were meant to appease Hindutva communalists and the RSS. However, the Chief Minister's office clarified on Tuesday that Vijayan never referred to any particular place or region, or did he use the term anti-state or anti-national activities in his reported statements. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Swati Ajit, and produced by Vishnu Murlitharan. Follow www.onmanorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news and be sure to come back tomorrow.